Welcome everyone to Marble Machine 3, episode 2. I'm scared. I failed miserably with building Marble Machines before. I built 2 machines. The disappointment of my failures with those machines have kept me from really deciding to go into the Marble Machine 3 project. Ever since I failed with Marble Machine X, I've been kind of trying to make myself give up on the project. But I can't. I'm going to go ahead with this. I know I can do it, but there are some adjustments that I need to do to be able to actually finish this project. Let's take a look at the roadmap. We started already with the marble gate design. Then I did several videos on the programming cylinder design as well. Last week, I skipped ahead to the sound quality where I did the dynamic volume, different size marbles for different sounds. This week, we're going to go back to the top power input prototype. So this is Marble Machine 3 power input module. My new modular approach is already an improvement. You can see here that the Marble Machine X was basically just a fancy copy of the original machine, so it inherited the same design issues. To give Marble Machine 3 a chance, I had to throw out this preconception about how the Marble Machine should look. So I'm going for a much more modular approach, and I think Andrew Carpenter captured the idea pretty well in this sketch. The cool thing is working one module at a time. I don't have to, you know, angle grind the whole machine just because one module doesn't work. I can kind of go in and work in one module at a time. What I'm going to do is that I'm going to be disciplined and make a test cut of this piece. I have a bearing housing here, a pretty cool idea of using the bolts as bearing housings. For this design to work out, we need the tolerance to be perfect. Here's an illustration of what I'm trying to do. First, I have this disc with 8 holes, and then we have the bearing. In the 8 holes, we put 8 M6 bolts, and then we add a second disc and some nuts on the other side. And the whole task for today is to see how hard we want the bolts to clamp on the bearing side. By moving the hole pattern in and out like this, we can get different fits. If we make it too tight, the bolts won't fit. They will dig into the bearing like this. If I put the holes too far from the center, the fit will be too loose. So now I'm going to design 6 alternatives with different fits and test in real life which fit we like the most. This design have received quite a lot of criticism already. It's quite controversial. Everyone would rather have me using manually machined bearing housings, and that's a conventional method. And cost-wise, time-wise, and complexity-wise, that is just so much more work for me as project manager than having one supplier cutting these plates. Napkin math, I'm expecting this solution to be 100 times cheaper. So when you're arguing for machined bearing housings, you have to prove to me that they are 100 times better to make them worth considering. Next week, we will know when we're testing this in real life if this is as a stupid idea as everyone seems to think it is. I love it. I think it's brilliant. I've been wrong before, so only time will tell. First step is to find out the diameter of the bearing. Diameter is 52 millimeters, and now we want some bolt holes. I'm telling the circle to be straight above this point, and we want 8 of those circles. So now for a very interesting decision. How big should the holes be? Well, I've been thinking a lot about this. I'm trying to do DFM, design for manufacturing, so I do not want to post-process the parts if I can avoid it. I don't want to make the holes too tight, so I have to kind of drill them out manually to make the screws go through. Is it really going to be tight then if the hole is much larger than the screw? And the answer is yes, because if you think about it, the force is actually only going to press inside towards the outside edge of the bearing and then outside towards the edge of the hole. This is an M6 bolt, so in CAD this says 6 millimeter. It's not 6 millimeter in real life. It is 5.85. So the smaller circle is the screw. So now the bolt is tangential with the outside of the bearing. It's also tangential with the inside of the hole. So you can see that we would be left over with this much opening. So this would be kind of our CAD perfect tolerance. But we don't know if this will fit in the real world. That's why we're gonna make some alternatives and test cut them all. And I realized that I can be economical. I can actually make 2 different tolerances on the same test piece. So let's first do a tighter one. How much tighter do we want the next try to be? If we move the top one 0.1, the bottom one also 0.1. So actually we have a 0.2 total more space. I'm gonna go with 0.1 actually. So if we move in close now, you can see that the bolt is actually digging into the side of the bearing. I'm expecting this one to be too tight. I want one test piece that is too tight. So this piece is going to be 5mm stainless steel. I do need more test patterns. I'm going to move the bolts further out from the bearing. And now we should see that there is a little air here. But here's our three different patterns. I'm trying to learn a method for the whole My Machine 3 project. If this works, I can use the same bearing housing for the whole machine. I'm kind of developing a Lego kit to build my marble machine with. I'm trying to make a standard solution that I can just copy paste all over the whole project. Finally, to illustrate, here's the bearing mounted on top, and I extruded some fake bolts here for the first one. And if we look at it from the flat front, these bolts are actually digging into the bearing. That's the tightest fit. This one is completely tangential with the bearing, and everything else is looser fits. We have achieved the first objective of this video, to design these test pieces. Now we're going to move on to ordering them through the 24/7 Steel software. We're in the Sophia software, running on PC, so excuse the bad resolution. PCs apparently only go to 1080p. 4K is only for Mac, apparently. It's kind of crazy, actually, when you think about it. Let's open this step file into the software and check this out. We can already see how the machine is planning to cut this. So first of all, material, properties, plate material. Oh, okay. Oh no, you have to be kind of rocket scientist to understand what this says. They talk in trade secret language. So HRS, blah, 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 blah. They wouldn't stoop so low as to just write stainless steel, right? Probably not a lot of hobbyists sitting in this software. Overview of materials. Wow. Okay, here's the, I see. So let's just click the first one. Shouldn't that be the most basic one? This should be good. Quotations. We're gonna get a prize here and now. I'm excited. I'm gonna spend so much time in this tool. Ask for quotation. Offer request created. How much do I think this will cost? Perhaps €5 each? That was pretty expensive. Maybe because it's such a small order. Or I just had more money while I was doing Patreon. That could be it as well. So I think I'm paying like a startup fee here. I'm just gonna add a lot of copies of the parts. So yeah, it's getting cheaper the more you order. Company password. Send. Company password not correct. Okay, I have to call them. Thank you, Val. They stopped working 20 minutes ago. You know what is so typical? Today is Friday. I'm calling this company 20 minutes after they went home Friday evening. it's just so fantastic. I really feel like this ADHD reaction in my whole body, like of some kind of like aversion. It's such a mental Mount Everest for me, these kind of things. I'm so stupid with it. I'm just going to be patient, gonna call them Monday morning, and that's it. My emotional overreaction to these kind of obstacles are truly embarrassing. I feel like King Theoden in Helm's Deep when all hope is lost. And just like Theoden, I did a Hail Mary. I emailed 24/7 asking for my company password, and you know what? Monday morning, I felt like Aragorn looking up at Gandalf arriving because I had a reply with my company password. Dreams of a world where music are being played with marbles are yet alive. I'm entering my new password. Et voila, we have ordered the parts. Can you believe it? First part of the Marble Machine 3 is on their way, and I can tick the second box in the roadmap. Thank you all for witnessing my stupid and glorious battle.